We wanted to get back to Hawaii since Margaret was here for so many years, 27 years. And the plan was before she had just recently passed. And the opportunity kind of fell in our lap to kind of do a turnkey opening. So we're here for the next year.
Anthony Brown's family has represented artist Margaret Keane for decades. Keen Eyes Gallery has had a location in San Francisco for much of that time, but now a new space at the International Marketplace is turning heads.
Depending who it is and what age they are, since the movie came out, I've noticed there's been an influx of younger teens or a little bit older that have seen the movie, and they're just so enamored with her work. And they have no idea that she was up, at that point, she was in her 80s into 90s. And it just spoke to them.
Work is larger than life and very identifiable and iconic in Hawaii in particular.
The works known for their sad, large eyes since the 1960s. But back then, no one even knew she was the real artist behind these iconic faces. Her husband, Walter, falsely claimed credit for her work. She divorced him and moved to Hawaii. And in 1970, she told a reporter that her former husband had painted none of the big-eyed paintings. Then in 1986, Margaret called a dramatic paint-off challenge in a Honolulu court where she had brought a defamation suit against Walter. This scene was recreated for the biopic Big Eyes, starring Amy Adams.
Maybe I could sign it myself.
That sounds a bit confusing, doesn't it? Keen means me.
Margaret was able to paint a work in less than an hour. Her ex, who represented himself in the case, said he had a sore shoulder and could not paint. Margaret won the case.
I think a lot of the uncertainty about who did them would be cleared up.
Yes, over two decades, she left San Francisco and then she came here. And then there was that change in her work. She was doing a lot of urban motif or urban colors, meaning like gray or brown, very dark monotone colors. And then when she came to the island, then everything started brightening up, and then you saw the resurgence, especially with the influence of the Asian culture and then the animals, and then everything just started getting much brighter and happier as well.
So you may recall some of her paintings depicting scenes and subjects from Hawaii have been in the news in recent years, such as this one. It was stolen 50 years ago from a Honolulu dentist office only to be returned to its original owner last year after being found through an auction sale of more than $30,000. Can't afford an original? There's other options.
We do have some prints here that are on canvas, like a giclée. So those start at $55 to $100, and then there's some that are signed. And those are a little bit more. Those started around 300. But then we also have limited editions and drawings. So, I mean, there's something for everyone at a certain price brackets. And then, of course, the original paintings and drawings.
So if you don't know where it is in the IMP, it's on the second floor. It's sort of around the little treehouse area on the second floor. That whole wing over there has really turned into a nice little gallery housing. Several galleries have popped up there. This one's just temporary, going to be around for about a year.
Very cool. I love the paint off in court.
I know. It's an amazing story.
Yeah.
Streaming on Netflix. Check it out.